We are here at the Adidas Nations 2008 with NBA former great Detlef Schrempf. How are you today, Detlef?
Doing great, thanks.
How are you enjoying the Adidas Nations?
It's been a great program. You know, we've been at it for a little over a year now. We've been all over the world, China, Brazil, Europe, Africa, and U.S. obviously, and putting this together. So it's really a good final product here with the experience, and we've had some pretty good games, and it's I think kids have really enjoyed it from all over the world.
So you're coaching the European group. You guys seem to have a pretty strong bunch, at least compared to last year. How has that been so far for you?
That's great. You know, last year we had kids that were 2 years younger than everybody. They were last year 15-year-olds competing with 17, 18-year-olds.
So right.
It was a learning experience for them. This year we probably have, out of the top 20 European players, I'd say we probably have about 8 of them.
Right.
And they're really competitive. They never practice together. You know, we had one practice here and then we played yesterday. So I think they're going to get a little better during this tournament. And they are all very competitive. And I think you're going to see some of those guys play professionally, maybe not here, but in Europe.
Right. How can you, what are you trying to accomplish here as far as, you know, is it more important to win as many games as you can, or is it more about player development? What is the goal?
It's, you know, the focus of it is that we want to provide these kids something special, an experience that they can really rely on, thinking, okay, you know, this is what it's all about. You know, we put them together with the best players, the best peers from around the world. And have them coached by, you know, great coaches with great experience, not just at the NBA level, but college, international. So we give them a taste of different things. With that, you know, they obviously supported by Adidas, and we want to build a relationship with them, communication with them, that they have support. So when they're thinking about, okay, should I sign with an agent, or should I go to college, or should I turn pro? You know, they have a professional that has an objective opinion about it to help them out. And you know, for them, it's pretty exciting coming here. And now, you know, it's more about teaching and building a relationship. But they're so competitive; they're all looking forward to the games because they want to win.
Right. Anybody impress you in particular from the young guys that you've coached so far, the Europeans?
Yeah, we have some pretty good talent. Individually, you know, they don't know each other yet, but we have a couple of good guards. Carl from France, you know, he's played in Italy last year, is a really good point guard. A Turkish kid who's really strong. Denis, who's you know, right-handed player, likes to the left, reminds me a little bit of a Carlos Boozer. And we had some really good outside shooters. We had Dodonovic, who's from Bosnia, a really good scorer. So Czech Republic player, two guard, that can probably jump as well as anybody here.
And Sadoransky.
Yeah, Tomas, who's you know, very competitive and all over the court. So we have some really good players. It's you know, fun getting to know them a little better and see what they do and try to help them out.
Flashing back to when you were 17, how were things different back then as far as the basketball industry? Did a support system like this exist, these kind of camps, for you?
Oh, no. We had I did a basketball camp in Europe when I was 16 or so. That you know, 30 guys bunked in a room, in a classroom together, and had three practices a day. And yeah, that's all we knew. You know, there was no gear. You know, there were no shoes handed out. There were no flights, you know, taken somewhere in a nice hotel. So it's definitely the, you know, the cream of the crop and top level.
How heavily were you scouted back at that age? How old were you when you got drafted, by the way?
I went to college, so okay. I was 21 when I got drafted.
Right.
So, but there was no scouting in Europe at, you know, 1980.
Right. So how did you end up coming over to the U.S. for college?
I came to high school.
Okay.
Yeah, just wanted to come over one year and, you know, and reached out to some high schools and ended up in the state of Washington.
It seems like that's becoming less and less of an option for a lot of international kids. NCAA has really cracked down on the amateurism rules. How do you feel about that as someone who's gone through that already?
I can tell you, honestly, I think the NCAA is very wrong in that regard. I have a German kid whose goal was to play college He played Division II, which is a semi-pro league in Germany, and did not get paid because he wanted to come to college, and the NCAA just told him he's ineligible for his college career.
The kid from Michigan?
Plays in Cologne.
He was supposed to go to Michigan, right, sorry.
Who has never taken any money
right.
for playing, but he had to play up in the second division because there was no competition at his level. So the NCAA just penalized him. He could have gotten paid already last year if he wanted it, but he wanted to go to college, and the NCAA penalized him for you know, basically being a good kid.
Right.
And I think they're so wrong about that, and actually I would encourage a group to get together and sue him because there are so many other kids that has happened to.
Do you think that that's going to really hurt the NCAA in terms of attracting international talent? And there's a lot of great players that have gotten Yasikevicius, and I mean, geez,
yes.
So many great names that have been through.
I think so. It takes a little bit away from the NCAA and international experience, which I think has been really good for the game. Because these kids, you know, for wherever they're coming from, you're talking about the Africans, Latin Americans that at age 16 are sent somewhere to be on a semi-pro team and they get $50 a month or something. And that's the only way out. You know, now you basically discriminate against them and don't give them a chance to really get further ahead because you take that option away from them.
Are you surprised by some of the NBA players recently getting up and leaving for Europe, like Josh Childress, for example, Carlos Arroyo? Surprised you at all?
Yes and no. I mean, in basketball, all over the world is pretty darn good. You know, you go and there's different atmosphere and different national pride, and now there's some pretty big money elsewhere.
Right.
You know, it used to be that you do that as a leverage point in negotiations, but you know, now guys are actually going over there and playing, and I think some will really like it and some will not.
So, right.
Remains to be seen.
Right. Detlef, I want to thank you so much for your time. It's been very informative, and best of luck in the rest of the tournament, okay?
Thanks, appreciate it.